In 1935, an American psychologist by the name of John Ridley Stroop invented the Stroop Test. That is, a word appears on screen that is the name of a colour, but it appears as a different colour, and it confuses the mind. It occurred to me with the tube map that there's a lot of colours that we instinctively know, so how much fun would it be if we then change some of those colours around?
So here are the 11 tube lines which we all know and love, and here are the colours that are represented by those lines. And I've got 5 tests for you. Try and do them in real time and make a note of which ones you found easy and which ones were harder to do. Test number 1. Okay, name the line that is represented by the coloured block on the screen. E.g., here the answer is Victoria. Ready? And go. Test number 2. We'll make it a bit harder now. This time you have to name the colour that is represented by the word shown. E.g., here the answer is yellow for the circle line. Ready? And go. Test number 3. Now for some fun without the colour blocks. We're going to colour the words instead. Here you have to name the line that the colour represents. E.g., here the answer is district. And off you go. Test number 4. Alright, as before, you still need to name the line that the colour represents, but the words now show the names of those colours, not the lines. So in this example, the answer would be Metropolitan. Ready? Off you go. And finally, test number 5. We're back to colour blocks, but the colours of the line have also changed. And what you need to do is again name the line that the colour of the word represents. E.g., in this case, the answer is the Piccadilly line. Ready and go. And that's the London Underground Stroop Test, changing colours which you know so well that it really confuses the mind. Let us know how you got on in the comments below, which bits you found easy and which ones you found hard. And I'll leave you with the idea of a tube map where all the colours have also completely changed.